I request participant one Inest 144 to start the presentation. And kindly kindly start the webcam.
Good evening, sir. Am I audible, sir?
Yeah, you are audible. Just keep your webcam on.
Good evening, sir. I am Kaveri. I am pursuing my B.Pharm final year in Sarojini Naidu Vanita Pharmacy Mahavidyalaya in Hyderabad. Now, I would like to present a poster regarding topic antibiotic resistance and its preventive measures. So, let me introduce with the topic, sir. So, antibiotic antimicrobial resistance in bacterial pathogen is a challenge that is associated with high morbidity and mortality. So due to this antimicrobial resistance, there is lot of mortality rate, and different bacteria have different patterns for multi-drug resistance, which cannot be treated or controlled by conventional antibiotics. So there is a dearth of effective treatment for controlling the resistance developed by the bacteria. So methods involved for developing resistance are by biofilm formation, antibacterial agents uptake, virulence, and Staphylococcus aureus, Clostridium difficile, vancomycin resistance bacteria. So through these methods, bacteria are developing resistance towards the antibiotics, and we need to develop some preventive measures so that we can control the antibiotic resistance. So results are strategies for controlling multi-drug resistance by bacteria include antimicrobial stewardship, active screening at-risk patients, and strict adherence to hand hygiene and effective room cleaning after discharge. So conclusion, due to multi-drug resistance in bacteria, there is an urge for development of techniques through which bacterial resistance can be controlled. Antimicrobial stewardship is such technique through which bacterial resistance can be controlled. That's it, sir. I would like to end my presentation.
First of all, Kaveri, your presentation is also very small. There are so many spaces you left blank by reducing the font size. Okay. So, what is the difference between gram positive and gram negative bacteria?
Gram positive bacteria have single cell layer, whereas gram negative bacteria has a double cell layer, sir.
Are you sure?
Yes, sir.
How can you confirm whether the given bacteria is positive or negative?
By using coloring agents, we can detect the gram positive and gram negative bacteria, sir.
Yeah, that specific test name only I am expecting from you. Okay, you are all pharmacy graduate and about to finish your B.Pharm. Okay, you should not tell commonly by some test. This is the way. So you have studied pharmaceutical microbiology, or you have studied pharmaceutical biotechnology courses, right?
Yes, sir.
In that, have you done subculturing, culturing, antimicrobial screening like couplet method or agar dilution method? Have you studied or have you performed in your practicals?
Yes, sir.
In that, have you performed any staining, gram staining kind of thing?
Yes, sir.
So why can't you correlate, or why can't you think, or why can't you tell something from that? Okay, so please be specific. It's a scientific presentation, no?
Yes.
So all information cannot be displayed in the poster, but you should have that brief background idea, no? You should have that basics. So without that, just referring one or two articles and copy pasting is will not serve this purpose. Okay, you should know first of all, if you talk about antibiotic resistance, means you should know from what is in the antibiotic, what is in the microorganism, what kind of strainings are used, what is the chemical used in that. So what is the principle, why that color change is happening, why that color change is not happening. All those are basics. So without that, you cannot enter into this antibiotic resistance. Please remember. Okay. Then in that methods, I could able to see only one thing you have mentioned about biofilm formation. So apart from that, is there any other reason or any other way by which the organisms can develop resistance?
By transduction, transformation also organisms, microorganisms.
So that comes under the category of mutation, right?
Yes, sir.
That is a generic term. With respect to bacteria, so apart from that, is there any other well-known established mechanism have you come across? Like quorum sensing? Or some kind of efflux pump. Have you heard about this? Apart from this biofilm formation, have you heard about some quorum sensing, or have you heard about some kind of drug efflux pump? Excuse me.
Hello.
Kaveri, are you there?
Yes, sir. I haven't heard about that, sir.
Come across that. Okay. So you should know. So these are all the recent findings. Okay. So this biofilm formation is very old. Okay. Then results, what you have written is not at all readable. So after discharge from the hospital, if you maintain hygienic, can you avoid or can you reduce the antibiotic resistance? You told, I think.
Yes, sir.
So what is the relationship between your personal hygiene and antibiotic resistance?
Sir, when person undergoes treatment regarding the bacterial infection, some of them will retain the bacteria which causes infection. So in order to remove all that, in order to kill the bacteria completely and disinfect the room, sir. Clean the room after discharging so that no bacteria can be present in the room while the other patients get being treated.
The radio quality is very poor. Voice is broken in between. I could not able to hear you clearly. Okay, so apart from that, you have not included one of the recent. So, can you brief me about that antimicrobial stewardship, what it indicates?
Sir, antimicrobial stewardship includes patient care and what are the medicines to be given to the patient and effective. Effective treatment for the patient and screening, detecting the microorganisms which cause the infection, and finding various ways to treat the infections.
Here and there, you are borrowing some words, and just as such, you are talking, no correlation. This is not the way. So please be thorough enough. So it's a review article kind of thing only you are presenting. You are not clear about what you have written, antimicrobial stewardship. Okay, so instead of that, you can think about some kind of new target identification. So some 10 targets people are working, you might have studied. Antibiotic which is of a cell wall inhibitor, antibiotic which is of protein synthesis inhibitor, or antibiotic which is of so So please leave all this well-established target and you focus on newer target. Okay, how we can stop this. So that will help you. Okay, so that is the recent field in AMR, antimicrobial resistance. Okay, yeah, thank you. Thank you. Yeah, other evaluator can ask, please.
Hello. Hello, Kaveri. Is it audible?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, first of all, I would like to congratulate you. Being a final BPharm students during COVID period, you are developing interest to participate in this poster presentation. On behalf of all, I congratulate you. First of all, you need a little more effort and interest to for presentation as well as towards research interest. This is just a review article, na? Okay, I need to know just only one question. What's the meaning of virulence?
It is a virus invaded in bacteria, sir.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
Kaveri, please, if you know, please tell. Okay, so don't muck up like this. Virus invaded the bacteria. What kind of answer, yaar? Kaveri, I am very sorry.
Okay.
If you know, you can clearly tell. Otherwise, sorry, sir, I don't know. Okay, you can tell. No problem at all.
Okay, no problem, madam. List out some examples of gram-positive and gram-negative bacteria. Hello? Can you give me the example for gram-positive?
Yes, sir. One second.
Pardon?
Staphylococcus aureus. Gram-positive bacteria, Staphylococcus aureus, and Clostridium,
okay, let it be. And also, I need your confirmation with what's the difference between morbidity and mortality? The meaning of morbidity and mortality.
Mortality is death rate, sir.
Okay.
And morbidity means condition where the person is suffering from disease, sir.
Mm-hmm. Okay, let it be. I will pass on to other evaluators to raise the questions or clarifications, please.
Can you tell me what are the other things by which we get the antibiotic resistance?
Other mechanisms are transduction, transformation, horizontal gene transfer, sir.
Yeah, but as for major thing is that there are so many things that happen in the medicinal field that consumption of higher antibiotics is taking place, and that's why the major things are happening around, and that is what is the major issue. So do you find any regulation over this this kind of uses and consumption of antibiotics?
They should be used properly, and before treating the bacterial infection, one should go to the active screening so that we can identify the bacteria and correct antibiotic should be given. And yeah, combination of antibiotics can also be used to treat this antibiotic resistance.
Okay, we can take another one. We can stop and take next candidate for the presentation.
Now I request